Hello, JK friends. Today I brought you to the Diversity Harbor because it is my favorite place to walk while we're social distancing. Don't worry guys, I have my mask on and I'm very far away from other people. But I brought you here because this is where I know a lot of animals live and I see them all the time when I'm on my walks. And just to prove to you guys how much I love you, I have a horrible fear of birds. They're everywhere. And there are geese and ducks and seagulls and all kinds of critters out here. But today we are going to be talking about animal homes. So because there's no animals in my home, I just had to go and visit theirs, you know. And unfortunately, animals don't really know how to follow health rules. So the birds are getting closer, guys. So they don't really know what it means to social distance. So I'm just gonna keep walking, maybe see some more kinds of creatures when I'm out in Lincoln Park. And in a little while, I'm going to tell you what kinds of things we're going to be making today to learn more about animal homes. So, like I said, there are lots of animals that are out here today. And while ducks and geese are great, and we are going to spend a lot of time talking about ducks in our class, there are a couple of animals that I think just build really, really interesting homes. Now, the animal homes, do not worry, I'm not going to be making them while I'm out here in the middle of the harbor. I am going to be making them back in my apartment where all my supplies are, but I will go ahead and tell you which animals we are going to be making homes for today. So, these are animals that are a little bit smaller than the ones you may think of normally when you think of animal homes. These animals are actually creepy crawlies. They are insects. Well, actually, one of them is not an insect. It's an arachnid. The three animals we're going to talk about today are one, honeybees, two, spiders, and three, ants. And the reason I want to take a look at these animals' homes is because they put a ton of work into building them and they're really, really beautiful on the inside. So I hope you're looking forward to joining me back in the studio while we create these animals' homes today. But first, I'm gonna finish my walk. So guys, I found this really cool tree down by one of the ponds. I feel like this is the perfect place to tell you about the different animal homes that we're gonna be making today. I told you the first home we're gonna be making is a honeybee hive. Now if you've never seen the inside of it, there's a part of a beehive that's called a honeycomb. And it has this shape that has six sides, and that shape is called a hexagon connection sign, if you already knew that. This is the part of a bee's home where they make exactly, honey. So the materials I'm using to make my honeycomb are a toilet paper roll, some paint, and some paper. Now, this part is kind of tricky, but once you figure it out, it's really, really helpful. I am making a stamp out of this toilet paper roll by folding it into the hexagon shape that goes inside of a honeycomb. Then I'm making a background with the yellow paint, just like this. And once the page is covered, I spread out some black paint on a plate and use my stamp to create the honeycomb pattern. And for some reason, my paint had lots of bubbles when I used the stamp. Last one, and of course, I'll add in some honeybees. It is their home after all. Mm-hmm. the second animal home we are going to be making is a spider web. I'm pretty sure you guys all know what a spider web looks like, but today to make mine, I am going to be using skewers, which is just a fancy kitchen word for stick. Any kind of sticks will do. Popsicle sticks, chopsticks, sticks. And I'm also going to use string and maybe a little bit of glue to pull this off. JK friends, I am going to be attempting to weave a spider web with string in a circle motion, just like this spider is doing. However, that can be really tricky for JK hands to pull off, so if you would like to start by drawing or painting this pattern, might be a better idea. The first thing I did was tie all of these skewers together. And I made a really secure knot around the middle so that the sticks wouldn't move once I started weaving in a circle pattern. And then I started the process of weaving my web. And last but not least, I am going to be making an anthill. For this anthill, you are going to need paint paper, washi tape, or another kind of tape like painter's tape that you can easily peel off of something, and a paintbrush, some glue, and either sand or dirt. And because I just bought new potting soil, I'm gonna use dirt.
Now you can't tell from the outside of an anthill, JK friends, but ants actually dig tons of tunnels that even have different rooms. Not exactly like this. More just like this, but they dig tons and tons of tunnels and it makes a beautiful design. Now, let me show you how I'm going to make my anthill tunnels. First, I'll go ahead and draw the shape of an anthill. This you can easily see because it's above the ground. And now to make my tunnels, I'm going to lay out where I want them to go using this tape. After all the tape is laid out in the pattern I want, I'm going to paint glue on top of the tape and fill in the whole shape of the hill. The parts that already have glue spread over them, just so it doesn't dry up too quickly, I'm going to go ahead and put my dirt on top. If you're using dirt or sand, make sure it's dry or it'll have a hard time sticking to your paper. think that looks pretty good. Let's add some ants. JK friends, out of the honeycomb, the spider web, and the anthill, which one of these animal homes was your favorite? Maybe you have an animal home that's your favorite that we didn't see today. Maybe you'll have a chance to explore and find some new ones. If you have the opportunity, JK friends, wherever you are, and as long as you're being safe, see if you can go outside and discover a new animal home. This is my challenge to you. Thanks for joining me and happy exploring!